climate change, especially about global warming. So to begin with, we have to understand what is climate change. It's the change of the average climate over time, and the greater the magnitude of climate changes, the more unstable the climate becomes. And there are three characteristics of it. First, acid deposition, which refers to rain, snow, other forms of precipitation with pH value less than 5.6. And then ozone depletion, which can increase the amount of ultraviolet radiation from sun into our Earth's surface. And finally, global warming, which we're gonna be focusing on today. Now here's a question, what causes global warming? First, the large amount of carbon dioxide produced by burning coal, petroleum, and wood. And this causes a greenhouse effect. As we can see in the picture, the solar energy comes into our Earth's surface with greenhouse gases. Of course, most is carbon dioxide. And some heat is fortunate enough to escape to space, but most heat is contained in the atmosphere, and this is what we call greenhouse effect. Then with the accumulation of greenhouse gases, the energy absorbed and emitted by our Earth atmosphere is not balanced. Well, in short, more energy in, but less energy out. Finally, the rising global temperature, like this. Maybe this graph is easier to understand. And to show how significant the temperature increases, here's some data. From 1981 to 1919, the global average temperature has increased by 0.48 degrees Celsius compared with 100 years ago. And in the 20th century, the world's average temperature climbed by about 0.6 degrees Celsius. So it's time for us to cool the Earth. And as I mentioned, the origin of global warming is the production of carbon dioxide. I mean, to cool the Earth, we have to reduce the carbon emission. But how to reduce it? I would like to divide it into two parts. First, the reduction, and then the renewable energy. Well, as normal high school students, what can we do in our daily life? I have three methods about traveling by public transportation. First, the buses, which is only 1/25th of the carbon emission of private cars. And then underground, which is only 1/7th of the emission of buses. And finally, bicycle, which has zero emission. And about living habits, turning off the lights when leaving, turning the air conditioner to 26 degrees, and saving paper. Now about renewable energy. I went to the University of British Columbia last summer for an exchange program called the Future Global Leaders, and I was just in the department about global warming, about renewable energy, so I will introduce solar energy. Solar energy is radiant light and heat from the sun that is harnessed using a range of ever-evolving technologies such as solar heating, like the solar thermal energy on the Wikipedia. Too much information, right? I'll explain it. It's a device that absorbs solar radiation and transfers the resultant heat energy to a heat transfer medium. But why it can reduce the carbon emission? Well, as I mentioned, most of the world's energy is generated by burning coals, but we can use solar heater to provide energy, and it is proved by NASA that our sun will keep burning in the following 8 billion years. And fortunately, we have already had many solar energy devices, like this. And I believe with our human efforts, our Earth will be as cool as she should be one day. Thank you.